You might think that your device is clean, but malware doesn't always show itself. The thing is, it doesn't always pop up with a big warning. Sometimes it just waits, silently watching, logging your keystrokes, draining your battery, or hijacking your files. By the time you notice that something's actually wrong, it could have already stolen your passwords, locked your data, or turned your laptop into a crypto miner. And the worst part, you probably let it in without even realizing it. Yeah, malware sounds like one of those tech problems that only happens to other people, but the truth is, it hits millions of users every single year. Phones, laptops, tablets, you name it, it could have malware on it. And it doesn't just crash your system. It can steal your passwords, hijack your webcam, lock your files, or secretly mine crypto until your device just completely melts down. Here's the problem. Malware is getting smarter and smarter, and if you don't know what to look for, you won't even realize that it's there until it's too late. But once you understand how it works, you can spot it early, shut it down fast, and dodge the damage completely. Hey everybody, and welcome back to Safety Detectives, and in today's video, we're breaking down the most common types of malware, how they sneak into your system, the red flags to watch for, and how to stay safe without needing a cybersecurity degree. So first of all, what is malware really? Well, let's start with the basics. Malware is short for malicious software. That encompasses pretty much anything designed to mess with your system, steal your data, spy on you, lock your files, or just straight up break stuff. It's kind of like digital graffiti, except instead of spray paint, it's stealing your credit card info while frying your CPU. And not all malware is gonna work the same, so let's break this down with the biggest types that you actually need to know about. First is viruses. Let's start with the classic. Think of a virus like a parasite. It needs a host file, usually something you open or run in order to activate. But once it's in, it spreads itself by injecting itself into other files, corrupting data, crashing programs, and generally making your system act like it's drunk. The scary part, you usually invite it in by clicking something that you thought was safe. And yes, iPhones can even get hit by this as well. Now, if you're worried that your phone might already be infected, then check out our step-by-step video. It'll walk you through exactly what to do fast. Okay, second is worms. Worms are like a virus's more independent cousin. They don't need a host file to spread, they are the payload. Once they're on your device, they replicate and spread across networks on their own. That's how a single infected computer can suddenly take down an entire office. Even if they don't break anything, they can still slow everything down by clogging up bandwidth and hogging resources. Third is Trojans. Named after that sneaky wooden horse from ancient Greece, a Trojan pretends to be harmless, like a free app, an email attachment, or even an update. But once you install it, boom, it opens the door to all sorts of chaos, spying, stealing, or even letting hackers take control of your system. It's not the malware itself that's smart, it's the trick that gets you to trust it. Fourth is spyware. Spyware is the creep of the malware world. It hides itself in the background, watching everything you do, your passwords, your emails, your credit card numbers, and everything in between. You won't see that it's there, but it'll just quietly sit in the background, collecting your data and sending it off to someone that you definitely didn't give permission to. And yes, it can even track what you type, and that's why keyloggers fall under this category. Super fun, right? Okay, fifth is ransomware. This one is brutal. Ransomware locks up your files or your entire device and demands money in order to get them back. Pay the ransom and maybe you'll get your stuff back. Don't pay and you're probably out of luck. The worst part, it often spreads throughout innocent looking emails or shady downloads, and once it's in, there's really not much you can do unless you've got backups or solid protection. Sixth is Adware. Not all malware is out to ruin your life. Some just want to ruin your browsing experience. Adware floods your screen with pop-ups, redirects you to weird websites, and tracks your clicks to serve more annoying ads. It's like a pushy salesperson who followed you home, got into your house, and now just won't shut up. Sometimes it's just a nuance, but other times it is a gateway to much more dangerous stuff. Seventh is Rootkits. Rootkits are malware in stealth mode, and they don't mess around. They dig deep into your system, like really deep, to give hackers admin level access. Once installed, they can disable your antivirus, hide other malware, and run commands like they own the place. They are very hard to detect and even harder to remove. It's like giving someone the keys to your house and then they go and change the locks behind your back. Eighth is RATs, or remote access Trojans. And nope, not the squeaky kind. These give hackers full remote access to your device. They can move your mouse, turn on your webcam, see your screen, log your keystrokes, basically anything you can do, they can do better and without asking. And most of the time, you won't even notice it's happening. Ninth is fileless malware. Here's a fun one, malware that doesn't use files. Fileless malware lives in your computer's memory using legit programs like PowerShell or your browser to carry out its attacks. No sketchy downloads, no obvious file to scan, and when you reboot, poof, it's gone. It's stealthy, slippery, and annoyingly effective. 10th is cryptojacking. Imagine your device working overtime, not for you, but to mine cryptocurrency for some random hacker. That's called cryptojacking. It hijacks your CPU and GPU and silently drains your resources to generate profit for someone else. Your device slows down to a crawl, your fan sounds like it's a jet engine ready to take off, and you're left wondering why your laptop is having a midlife crisis. Number 11 is malwertising. Malicious ads on legit websites. Yep, that's a thing. Malwertising sneaks malware into online ads, sometimes even on big name sites. And the worst part is you don't even need to click, just loading the page can trigger the attack. So yes, that banner ad for one weird trick to get abs might actually be one weird trick to get hacked. 12th is browser hijackers. Ever open your browser and your homepage is suddenly some weird search engine that you've never heard of before? Yeah, that's a browser hijacker. It changes your settings, injects ads, and sometimes installs extensions without asking. It's annoying for sure, but it's also a sign that something's buried in your system and it's time to kick it out. Number 13 is backdoors. Backdoors are exactly what they sound like, a secret way into your system that skips all of the usual security checks. Once inside, attackers can steal data, install more malware, or control your device remotely. Some malware will even create its own backdoor, others exploit ones that already exist. Either way, it's like someone sneaking in through the basement window while your alarm system's watching the front door. Number 14 is hybrid malware. Why settle for one type of malware when you can mix and match? Hybrid malware combines different types, like a Trojan with ransomware or a worm with spyware. It spreads fast, it hits hard, and it's way harder to detect or remove because it's not playing by one set of rules. Think of it as malware on hard mode. Number 15 is wipers. Wipers don't necessarily want your data, they just want to destroy it. Once triggered, they will erase everything, files, system data, even your backups if they can find them. These are often used in target attacks where the goal isn't money, it's just chaos. If ransomware holds your data hostage, wipers just walk in and burn it to the ground. Number 16 is phishing. Phishing is the art of faking trust. You get an email or a message that looks legit, maybe from your bank or a delivery service or even your boss. But the link, well, it's fake. The attachment, malicious. Click once and you could be handing over your login details, credit card number, or open the door to a malware infection. Think of this as the digital version of someone showing up at your house in a delivery uniform and walking out with your TV. Number 17 is social engineering. This isn't about code, it's about people. Social engineering tricks you into doing something risky, like revealing a password or installing software that you shouldn't. It'll play on fear, urgency, trust, whatever gets you to act without thinking first. Phishing is just one example, but it can even happen over phone calls, texts, or even face-to-face. The weakest link in any system is usually human. So how do you protect yourself from malware? Okay, so now that we've covered the scariest types of malware villains, how do you actually not get wrecked by them? Well, let's break this down. First, get real protection. And no, Windows Defender isn't gonna cut it on its own. You need a solid antivirus with real-time protection. Norton is one of the best options in 2025. It catches pretty much everything, blocks dangerous sites before you click, and works across PC, Mac, and mobile. If you're using something outdated or free only, then you're really rolling the dice on that one. You can check out our full video where we break down what free tools actually protect you from and what they completely miss. It could save you from a really bad day, so definitely check that out. Second is to keep your stuff updated. Those annoying update pop-ups, well, they can fix some serious security holes. But if you ignore them, you're basically leaving your digital doors unlocked. Third, don't fall for the bait. Whether it's phishing emails, fake downloads, weird pop-ups, if it looks sketchy, it probably is. Always hover before you click, double check the sender, and trust your gut if you're not sure. Fourth, only download apps from legit sources. That free version of Photoshop on some random site, well, it's free because it comes with a surprise infection. Fifth, turn on real-time protection. Good antivirus tools constantly scan what you're doing in the background. And that's why malware can get blocked before it makes itself at home. And finally, back up your files. If ransomware hits, backups can be the difference between a mild headache and a complete digital disaster. So no, you don't need to become a cybersecurity expert, but a few small habits and a decent antivirus can save you a ton of time, money, and pain. So what did we learn? Well, malware comes in all shapes and levels of chaos, but most of it spreads the same way. Bad links, sketchy downloads, weak protection, but the good news is now you know how to spot it, block it, and shut it down before it does any real damage. So if you want to stay ahead, then check out our video on the best Android antiviruses in 2025, where we break down all of our top picks that we actually trust. Also, if you've got a question, maybe a horror story, or a favorite antivirus that saved your butt, then drop a comment down below. We would love to hear from you, and we actually read them. Also, while you're down there, be sure to hit the like button and subscribe to get more online safety videos just like this one in our future content. Because staying safe online doesn't stop with malware. But as always, thank you so much for watching, and we'll see you in the next video.